Start by disconnecting either the ignition coil's connectors or the injector's connectors to identify which cylinder is not working properly. But don't remove the ignition coil with the connector on. Any high voltage spark generated and has no way out might arc backwards and damage the ECU. When removing any ignition coil connector or the injector connector and the car idling doesn't change, so you'll know that this cylinder is not working properly, but you don't know what's the problem yet. Cylinder is not working properly. So try swapping this ignition coil with another one and check if the problem is transferred to the other cylinder. If yes, the ignition coil is bad, and if it is still in the same cylinder, then there's another problem. Now the problem has transferred to the other cylinder, then this ignition coil is bad. It's fixed now, and the engine returned to normal idling. Now testing the ignition coil with a multimeter. This is a new one, it should be very good. The ignition coil has primary and secondary coils. The primary coil should have a resistance around 0.2 and 3 ohms and the secondary coil between 5,000 to 20,000 ohms, depending on the model and specifications. Ohm meter on 200 ohms. This is the primary coil terminals. And between each of the input terminal and the output terminal is the secondary coil. Now testing the primary coil. Now testing the secondary coil. Set the multimeter on 20,000 or 20k ohms.